A significant ratcheting up today of diplomatic tensions between Canada and China, with China issuing a travel advisory for its citizens planning to visit Canada. The move, an apparent tit-for-tat response to this. Canada updating its travel advisory for China, posting this overnight, telling Canadians to exercise a high degree of caution in China due to the risk of arbitrary enforcement of local laws.
The latest escalations come after Canadian Robert Lloyd Schellenberg was sentenced to death by a Chinese court yesterday for drug smuggling. It's an outcome some human rights advocates say was politically motivated. Just hours after the decision was handed down, Trudeau criticizing the sentence.
It is of extreme concern to us as a government, as it should be to all our international friends and allies, that China has chosen to begin to arbitrarily apply death penalty, as in this case, facing a Canadian.
Today, China reacting directly to Trudeau's comment. This Chinese foreign ministry spokesperson accusing Canada of making irresponsible remarks, and she's urging Canada to respect China's judicial sovereignty. And the same spokesperson taking aim at what China calls Canada's abuse of legal procedures. When it comes to the arrests of top Chinese exec Huawei CFO Meng Wanzhou in Vancouver last month, something that's deeply angered China. Meng is now out on bail, facing possible extradition to the U.S. for allegedly violating American sanctions on Iran. While her arrest was at the request of the U.S., Beijing is apparently putting its focus on Canada. After warning of unspecified consequences in the wake of Meng's arrest, China detained two Canadians. Former diplomat Michael Kovrig and entrepreneur Michael Spavor accusing them of endangering state security. Canada has called for their immediate release.
And an update from Minister of Foreign Affairs Chrystia Freeland on the case involving the Canadian sentenced to death in China. Freeland says Canada has requested clemency for Schellenberg.